Have a nice day, student. Today we discuss about the Ctenophora. Ctenophora is the phylum of non-chordate. Non-chordate means the animals which having no notochord, we call them non-chordates. And Ctenophora is the phylum of non-chordates. These animals are known as the Combocephalies. These animals are found in the aquatic environment or in the water, so we call them aquatic animals, as well as they are found specifically, or most animals are found in marine water, so their habitat is marine or marine habitats. These animals are transparent, so we call them jelly. These animals having the jelly like structure or jelly because they having the transparent body. These animals having the comb plates on their body, ciliated comb plate. Cilia are the structure which are utilized or which are used by the living beings for the locomotion. So in these animals, cilia are present in the plate form or in the lining. So 8 ciliated plates are present in these animals, so we call them comb jelly, and these cilia are used for the locomotion. These animals are the largest animals which having the cilia for locomotion. These animals are the multicellular in their structure. They having the tissue grade level of organization. These animals are triploblastic. It means they having the 3 germ layer. So we call them triploblastic animals. It means these animals having the ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. These animals having no body cavity, so we call them acoelomate. It means these animals are without coelom or without true body cavity, so we call them acoelomate. It means there is no true body cavity. These animals having the mesogelia. These animals are the triploblastic, so they having the 3 layers. So in the 3 layers, they having the a specific layer, we call them mesogelia. Mesogelia is also present in the Cnidaria group or in the Cnidaria animal. So these animals also having this layer, we call them mesogelia. Mesogelia is the acellular layer. It is without cell. It is a protein layer which is present between outer and inner membrane. So this is the structure, we call them comb jelly. They having the ciliated plate on their body surface. These animals have the ciliated plate on their body surface. So these animals having the 8 ciliated plate on their body surface. These 8 ciliated plate are present in this region. This is the 8 ciliated plate which are present on the body surface. They are useful for the locomotion. Now these animals are the radially symmetrical. They are divided in 2 parts on the through their radius, so we call them radially symmetrical. Symmetric means the animals can divide into the 2 equal parts through a plane or through the radius, so we call them radial symmetrical. These animals also having a specific cell, we call it the photocyte cells. Photocyte cells are used or they are responsible for the bioluminescence. Bioluminescence, it means these animals emit the light, sunlight especially, so we call them bioluminescence. These animals emit the sunlight. The important feature in these animals, they are having the sensory organs also. Sensory organs are present in these animals. These animals also having the neurons which form the network. And this net is act as a brain or responsible for the control and coordination in the animal. So these are the comb jelly or Ctenophora animals. The common example of this animal is Cestum is the common example of the comb jelly. Now we discuss about the next phylum, Platyhelminthes. Next phylum, Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes. These animals are known as the flatworms because these animals are dorsoventrally flattened. So these animals are known as the flatworms because these animals dorsoventrally flat, so we call them flatworms. In this group, these animals are also acoelomate. It means they have no body cavity in their structure. These animals are the parasitic and mode of nutrition. They are the parasite. So we call them parasitic mode of nutrition in these animals. These animals are multicellular. They have the organ level of organization. These animals having the organs in their body structure. So we call them organ level of organization. These animals are the bilaterally symmetrical. It means animal body can divide into two equal parts through a single plane. So we call them bilaterally symmetrical. These animals are the triploblastic. Triploblastic, it means these animals having the three germ layer, outer ectoderm, inner endoderm, and middle layer we call them mesoderm. These animals are dorsoventrally flattened, so we call them flatworms. Dorsoventrally flattened. Dorso, it means upper surface, and ventral, it means lower surface of animal. So these animals are flattened from upper side and lower side, so we call them dorsoventral flattened. Now next picture of this animal. These animals having the respiration through the phlegm cells. It means these animals excrete, or they show the excretion, or they perform the excretion through the phlegm cells. Phlegm cells are the excretory cells or excretory structures in these animals. This is an example of the flatworm animal. This is the planaria. This is the planaria animal. This animal is an example of flatworm planaria animal. It having a very high power of regeneration. If you cut this animal in two or three parts, every part will develop into the new animal. So we call them, they having the very good regeneration power. These animal also having the hooks and sucker in their mouth. Hooks and sucker for obtaining the food from the host. Because they are the parasite, so they obtain the food from the host. So the hooks enter into the host body and injure them, and suckers suck the food from the host body. These animals can perform the sexual as well as asexual mode of reproduction, or reproduce by sexually or asexually reproduction method. So these animals perform both the type of reproduction. If you're talking about the examples, so these animals, common example flatworm is, the common examples are Tinea solium. Generally we call it the flatworm. Another example, liver flu. And another example is planaria. These are the some examples of flatworms. Now we discuss about next phylum. We call them nematodes or Escalminthia. These animals are known as the nematode, and the common name of these animals is called roundworm. Round, it means these animals having their cylindrical body, so we call them roundworm. The common example of this phylum is the Ascaris. Ascaris is a common example of this phylum. It causes the disease in human being also. So it act or it living inside human being, human children, as a parasite. These animals having the triploblastic, it means they having the three germ layer. These animals show the bilaterally symmetrical, or these animals are the bilaterally symmetrical. These animals are the pseudocoelomate. Pseudocoelomate, it means false body cavity. Pseudo, it means false, and coelomate, it means body cavity. The animals, they're having false body cavity because of pseudocelomate. But what is the meaning of pseudocelomate? The body cavity is developed normally by the mesoderm, but in the case of pseudocelomate, the body cavity is not developed by, our body cavity is not lined by mesoderm. We call them pseudocelomate. So these animals which are having the body cavity but it doesn't line by mesoderm, we call them pseudocelomate. These animals having the alimentary canal which having the both the ends, mouth and anus. So these animals having the alimentary canal which perform the digestion, but there is no need any digestion because these animals are the parasite or parasitic in mode of nutrition. So there is no need of digestion of food. There is no circulatory system in these animals. These animals are the free living, or they are living in the fresh water as well as in the marine water. These animals are reproduced through the sexual reproduction, so they can perform the sexual reproduction. It means there is the sexual reproduction. In this group, especially in the case of Ascaris or roundworm, these animals show the sexual dimorphism. What is the meaning of sexual dimorphism? Sexual dimorphism means animals are separated. Animals are separated on the basis of their morphology. It means male body are different and female bodies are different. It means we can define the male and female. In the case of Ascaris, male are normally short in length and females are the longer as compared to the male. So we call them sexual dimorphism because animals can identify on the basis of their length if they are male or female. So in the case of Ascaris, they are having the sexual dimorphism. This is the Ascaris animal. It having the mouth as well as anus. So it having the complete alimentary canal. This is the structure, we call them pseudocelomate. And what is the meaning of pseudocelomate? We have already discussed. It having the outer ectoderm, inner endoderm and mesoderm. So body cavity is present but it is not lined by mesoderm, so we call them pseudocelomate. So body cavity is pseudocelomate. So these animals having the body cavity which is pseudocelomate. The example of this group is, first, very common example of this group is roundworm, or we call them Ascaris. Another example of this group is filarial worm, which is cause the disease, we call them elephantiasis. Elephantiasis is a disease in which the limbs of a patient become limbs of elephant. So we call them elephantiasis. In the elephantiasis disease, the limbs become swelled up due to the excessive accumulation of lymph in their limbs. So this is the phylum, we call them Nematoda or Ascalmithes. Thanks for today.